Hello, my name is Claire, and welcome to the BA Test Kitchen. No, obviously I'm kidding, although I do freaking love that show. Claire, call me. Love you. But we are in my kitchen today because this week in questions that won't leave my brain alone is, why can you eat this and this, but not this? What is it about chicken in particular that makes undercooking it so bad? Okay, so at the end of my research for this video, I found that SciShow actually did a video answering this question on their channel about 2 years back, and so I considered maybe just scrapping this one. But here's the thing, theirs is much shorter and it goes a lot faster because that's their style, and I still really want to talk about microbes, so... Still gonna do the video. Okay, here it is. Bye. And that's kind of the short answer. It does all come down to microbes. The difference in safety is the difference in the pathogens that make their homes in certain animals, and in turn, the consumer's susceptibility to those pathogens. Just a quick little note here. This is actually why you can eat steak almost totally raw, like really, really, really rare, because mostly the only part of it that's gonna be contaminated by any bacteria is the outside of it, because it comes into contact with all kinds of yucky stuff during the processing that you wouldn't necessarily want to put in your mouth. But because that meat comes from the muscle of the animal, it's far enough away from the animal's gut, which is probably where most of the bad bacteria would live in the animal. So the muscle itself is pretty sterile. It's just the outside that you are technically sterilizing when you cook the outside.
So as long as your beef was prepared properly and your butcher didn't butcher the butchering process and contaminate the beef with stuff from inside the cow's guts, then you're not gonna need to cook the whole thing all the way through to kill anything bad. This is why you can't eat raw ground beef without probably getting pretty sick. Because that contaminated outside has gotten all mixed in with everything else when it got all ground up. Plus, ground beef is often made from multiple animals, not just one. So if there's one bad cow in the mix there, then that whole huge batch of ground beef is contaminated. So, you know, maybe think again before ordering your hamburger rare. Now, let's compare beef to pork, for instance, which is another meat that doesn't often get served raw. And that's because pork is highly susceptible to infection by several parasites, especially one called trichinella, which is a kind of roundworm, and which is highly transferable to humans if the pork is undercooked. And this pretty much comes down to what pigs eat. See, cows are herbivorous ruminants, and so they have a very different digestive system and different microbiota from humans. So any parasite that's likely to infect cows is going to be less transferable to humans because our bodies are so different. Pigs, on the other hand, are omnivores and have a much more similar digestive system to ours and are more likely to eat parasites that would be more than happy to live inside of us. You can still get tapeworms from both beef and pork, though. This is why the FDA exists. Let's consider fish, too. I'm a huge sushi lover, and I have often wondered why I've never gotten sick from eating raw fish. Well, I'm lucky, and I live in a place where the regulations around raw fish preparation are such that it's most often served in a way that is safe. But it also, again, comes down to microorganisms. Fish, obviously, are even farther away from humans on the similarity tree. I mean, they do live in a whole different environment. So in terms of parasites that can infect fish versus parasites that can infect humans, we're looking at more of a two entirely different circles situation than a true Venn diagram situation. Fish also tend to be served whole, not ground or mixed up, which lowers the likelihood that one infected organism will make the whole batch of food contaminated, therefore lowering the frequency of infection, especially by bacteria. And for the most part, the way fish are caught and processed plays an important role too. Farmed fish are closely monitored in a controlled environment and are therefore less likely to be harboring harmful parasites than wild-caught fish left to their own devices at the mercy of nature's nematodes. Plus, fish are mostly flash frozen right after harvest. This kills almost any parasites or parasite eggs that may be in there. On the other hand, farmed fish and shellfish are more likely to harbor harmful bacteria than wild-caught fish because they've been raised in crowded conditions on top of each other's waste. Vibrio vulnificus, for example, is a highly serious, often fatal bacterium found in shellfish populations. And studies have shown that aquaculture, that is, the farming of fish and shellfish, actually selects for increased virulence of pathogens like this.
But I don't mean to freak you out too much. For most raw meats and fish, bacteria is most likely to be introduced in the processing and packing of it. This means that if you live in a country with pretty tight food regulations, your meat has been sanitized and also probably kept cold enough throughout the processing, packaging, and transport that bacteria haven't been given the opportunity to grow into the meat, and any bacteria on it can easily be cooked to death. And that brings us to chicken. Chickens, believe it or not, are also omnivorous, which exposes them to more parasites. But that's not even really the top concern. Even chickens raised on a vegetarian diet are often kept in pretty squalid conditions, deep in their own waste and the waste of other animals. So they're generally pretty rife with bacteria, like Salmonella and Campylobacter species. And while being different from humans is what makes fish a little more safe in terms of parasite transfer, being different from humans is actually what makes chicken more dangerous in terms of bacteria. These perilous bacteria live very happily in the bird's digestive tract, and they actually don't do the bird any harm. So they just hang out there until the chicken is slaughtered for food, which is when we eat it, and those bacteria are really bad for us. Plus, chickens are small animals that are difficult to butcher without exposing the rest of the meat to the gut bacteria of the animal. And remember, the gut is where the bad stuff mostly lives. Which is to say that much more of a chicken gets contaminated with the animal's guts than, say, a cow does by its own microbiota in processing. All of this is why many chicken producers feed their chickens antibiotics, so the chickens carry less bacteria in the first place. But research is indicating that even if the disease doesn't get passed to you, overuse of antibiotics in animals raised for food is contributing to antibiotic resistance in those animals. You wanted to get rid of the thing, and then you mismanage the only weapon that we have against that thing to make that thing even stronger and harder to fight? Bad idea, my dudes. Antibiotic resistance in these kinds of enteropathogens is not something we want to contend with. And some antibiotic-resistant strains of bacteria then pose an increased risk to those who interact with the live animals, like farm workers who contract livestock-associated MRSA, for example. I mean, surely there's a better way to avoid infection in farm animals than just dosing them with huge amounts of antibiotics from the day they're born. Like, I don't know, maybe raising them more hygienically and humanely in the first place? So here's the short answer to the question we posed at the top. You can't eat raw chicken because chickens are exposed to way more bacteria when they're being raised for food, in part because of poultry farm conditions. Two, they're home to bacteria that doesn't bother them, but really bothers us. And three, it's pretty hard to butcher them cleanly. But that's raw chicken. If you cook your chicken really thoroughly, you should be fine.
Okay, last quick fun food fact for you here at the end of the video. There are several dishes from around the world, including from Japan, that involve raw or barely cooked chicken, and people eat these pretty regularly. It's still a pretty big risk, and you have to know that it was prepared really cleanly and really safely by somebody who really knows what they're doing, but still, it's kind of cool that it's a thing.
One thing that I guess I only really fully digested when I was writing this video is that even if the meat is properly cooked, you're still ingesting some of these pathogens. They've just been killed or neutralized so you don't get infected and experience symptoms. And if that squicks you out like it did me, you could always consider not eating meat at all, or at least trying to cut down to just a couple of days a week, which is a good move for the animals, the planets, and lowers your risk of being exposed to animal foodborne pathogens. I'm not trying to tell you how to live your life, it's just a thought. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. This is the second video in almost as many weeks. Who is she? Special thanks to my Patreon patrons, which are listed here, and you too can become a patron and support me making more videos like this by visiting my Patreon. The link is in the description box. Being a patron gives you access to behind the scenes footage, bloopers, and cool perks like stickers. Leave any questions for me down in the comments and make sure you subscribe to this channel to know when a new video comes out. And with any luck, I will see you next week. Bye.